Before you school in any university here in Ghana, do watch this video. Whether you are Ghanaian or whether you are from the diaspora, it is very informative and it will be of help to
us. And you're all welcome back to the SJS vlog, where we talk about fashion, lifestyle, and entertainment.
FJ.
So today,
with the strength of a woman, she Jackie says. With the power of a woman, she Jackie says. Everywhere she goes, every day, she Jackie says.
What's cooking, what's popping, SJS Nation, SJS fam? It's your favorite girl, she Jackie says, and I am back once again on your screens with another video. So thank you guys for watching my previous videos. Thank you guys for your comments. Thank you guys for your messages. And I hope my previous two videos on the do's and don'ts of what you're supposed to take to the industry was quite helpful. And yes, so in today's video, I'm going to be continuing with my series, and today you're going to be talking about things you're supposed to take note of, these things before you go to the university or before you go to school. Yes, before you go to school, you're supposed to take note of these things. In this video, these are not the stuffs so you're going to pack or something, but these are very essential information that applies to most universities here in Ghana. And these are the things that you're supposed to take note. If you are new here, don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to also share. And let's get right into today's video. So now, what next? You apply to the university here in Ghana, to Legon, to KNUST, to UEW. You got your admission. And yes, you got your admission letter. So I do have my admission letter here. And one thing I want you to take note of is your... You should carefully read your admission letter. Did I even carefully read my admission letter? I doubt I did. So you are supposed to carefully read your admission letter, and you don't want to fall a victim of what I did. You're supposed to take notes of the faculty that you are going into and know that if they've given you a four-year program or a two-year program, and also the dates of the registration and all whatever is stated in your admission. I hope you understand. But what I want you to take notice of is your application number. Take note of your student ID and your password and whatever. With your application number, that is what you are going to use to pay your school fees. This application letter is for University of Education Winneba, and your application number is the one that you're going to use to pay for your school fees. And that is how you get your index number. So when you're going to pay your school fees, you use the code that they send you and you use it to get your index number. You get a message. I got a message and I was 43. So my index number was 43 during my time. And the same application number, in some other schools, they call it serial number or whatever. This same application number is what you're going to be able to use to access your Wi-Fi on campus. That is your wireless network on campus. So you're supposed to take notes. You're also supposed to take notes of is your index number. Your index number is going to be used everywhere on campus. Your name is not important when you come to the university. Your index number is your identification in any university campus. You're supposed to take it serious. Forget about senior high school. Senior high school's index numbers were meant for WASI. Now, when it comes to the university, your index number is your ticket to everything. We don't use names. The lecturer will come to class and be like, index number 41, index number 42. The lecturers hardly mention our names. So take note of your index numbers. You're going to be, and when you go to school and you get your student's ID card, make sure you take it everywhere you go, because it is a requirement. All right, now what next? Join groups on campus. You know, we have, when it comes to universities, we have a lot of groups on campus. Now, what groups am I talking about? We have Ashanti Students Unions, we have Ghana Students Unions, we have Northern Students Unions. I don't know how they all have names of it. I joined the Ashanti Students Union because I had most of my education in the Ashanti region. So I joined Ashanti Students Union of Ghana. Yes, it's all groups on campus. So when you come, ask someone or find someone who is ahead of you, someone who is probably 200, 300, 400 students. Ask them that you want to join this group because they are very helpful. They connect you. It helps. You might probably be wondering, why should I join these groups? They are very essential. When you come to school in Ghana, try and find yourself. We have denominational groups. I am an apostolic member, so I joined the APOSA and I joined the ASU, which is Ashanti Students of Ghana. We have different groups. You find those groups, and we also have groups from your alma mater, from your senior high school. You try and find them, ask anyone, and try and join them. Why? Because they help you connect. So get someone to help you to join these groups, which are really essential, because university is all about I'd always say that most of the times you get to link with these people and you don't know where it might take you. I'm not saying join any occult, they are not occult groups, but they are groups that will be very beneficial to you. So try and find all these groups when it comes to the university. Another thing, before you school in any university, try and secure accommodation. So once you receive your admission letter, most of the times for my school, your accommodation, they will tell you the hall that you're affiliated to. So you go on the campus, you go to the university campus, try and secure an accommodation there. But if you can't get an accommodation, if you realize it's full, you try as much as possible to get a hostel in the diaspora. I hope you understand. You try as much as possible to get another hostel in the diaspora, because when you come, accommodation is very difficult to get on most university campuses. For Legon, I know they have a lot of halls, but when it comes to UU, they have few halls which accommodate students. So you don't leave your accommodation in the hands of other people. You try and do it yourself too, so that you didn't get any benefits of the doubt that you'd be there, you'd be wondering, okay, so I didn't do this, I didn't do that. So after you get your admission, try and secure an accommodation, because I've gotten a lot of questions from people that after I pay my school fees, what next? Bro, sis, you realize you don't have an accommodation. So try and secure an accommodation when you are coming to school. Before you come to school, don't wait and bring your stuff to come to school before you secure an accommodation. Try and do it before you come to school. Also, you are supposed to understand your program of study. Most people do not understand their program of study. I hope you understand. Get a senior, get someone who is ahead of you to explain your course of study to you. Because most people will come and they wouldn't even know that a course that they are being offered. I know when you go to school, your lecturers are going to ask you. But most of the time, the first day we enter class, our lecturers will be asking us questions about the course. Try and know more about the course before you enter the class. Try and know more about the course before you come to school. Research. Now, Google is everything. Google it. Go on YouTube. Go everywhere and find more about the course of study that you want to pursue. It is very important. Know the job prospects of it. Know the career wise and everything after school. What are you going to do with the course and all those kind of stuff. Know this before you come to school. All right. Now the next one is, you should be financially prepared. I'm not supposed to tell you that when you're coming, bring money. I'm not saying bring loads of money, but trust me, university life is difficult. It's all glamorous and on social media and all that, but trust me, it is very difficult, especially in big universities like University of Ghana, Legon. I hope you understand. Movements around, most of the times when you are going to school, it's not like senior high schools where you walk to your classrooms or whatever. When you come to university, your faculty or your lecture hall might be very far off from your hostel. Being financially prepared in terms of getting transport, there are a lot of things that you don't even have to call home for. So when you're coming, try and be financially prepared. Get money, because you're going to pay SRC dues. Dues that you're not even, you think you're not even supposed to pay, you're going to pay. So when you're coming, try and bring extra money. You don't want to make the mistake that I did, trying to, I wasn't financially prepared when I came. So I had to do a lot of paying, a lot of buying and all those kind of stuff. So try and be financially prepared when you are coming to school, because it is very important. Even in admission letter, when you read my admission letter that I have here, point number 10, it says that the university does not give financial assistance to students. It is therefore responsibility of students to arrange for their own sponsorship and maintenance during the period of study. It is all up to you. As I said earlier on, you should read the admission letter carefully, because everything you need to know about the university is in it. So I'll keep saying, be financially prepared, Chale. Trust me, read my lips. University life is a bit difficult. You're going to be cooking. No one provides food for you. You're going to be cooking yourself. So, I don't know, try, be financially prepared, trust me. You know, when you are coming, all these things, your parents don't know these things. So when you are giving them, and they give like chop money, oh, take this. But you know when you are coming, you're supposed to buy this, you're supposed to buy that. So this is just a tip that I'm giving you. It's a bonus something that I'm giving you, that be financially prepared when you are coming to school. Now, another thing is, try and come to school early and register early. You know, it's stipulated in the admission letter, the day that you're going to have your registration and all that. I hope you understand. Try and come to the university premises very, very early and register. Most people make the mistake. Most people will come later part by the time that their colleagues are done registering and all that. And you'd be left wanting, because you'd be confused. You don't know what to do. But when you come, you meet all your colleagues. And that's how most of the times you get to socialize and meet new friends. When you come, most of you don't know anything. So you'd be like, oh, Aiden, I'm also new here. Do you know this? And all, I hope you understand. So try and come early and register early and know everything about, because when you come early, you are well abreast about everything. School was set for us to come on 4th September. I remember I reported to school on 4th September. I went there, I was in school by 11. I did everything, I got to know everything on campus and everything. So by Monday, I was fully set. I was ready for lectures and all those kind of stuff. I'll be understand. So be prepared, be prepared. University is not like senior high schools where you open and 2 weeks later you start lectures, you start classes. When it comes to the university, know that some schools they'll open on Saturday and start lectures on Monday. So come and be prepared. Come early, register, start your lectures. Mind be mind open about everything and all those kind of stuff. The last but one thing I also want to talk about is be open-minded. Being open-minded is before you come to the university. I remember with Legon, people would be like, Legon people are like this, Legon people are like that, Legon this, when it comes to UCC, UCC people, it's all about learning, it's all about learning, it's all about learning, and they don't do this. All the guys, like, there are lots of stuff about people in different, when it comes to UW, UW people, they are like this, they are like that. Be open-minded when you come. Be open-minded. Don't have all these stuffs in your mind. Be open-minded. You are growing up. I hope you understand. So these are most of the things you're supposed to know when you're coming to the university. And know that, I keep saying this in my two previous videos, I said that, know that time is very precious and time is very essential when you come to the university. It is very essential. So try as much as possible to utilize your time very well. If you want me to do a video on utilizing your time properly in the university, just leave comments down below and I'll gladly do so, because I'm here for you guys. I'm doing all these videos for you. And I hope this video was quite informative. This video was helpful to some of you. Make sure that before you go to any university you've gained admission to, UEW, Legon, KNUSD, UCC, UHAS, UDS, you are fully aware of things that are going to go on. Sure. So thank you guys for watching today's video. I hope it was informative. I hope you learned something from it. Don't forget to like this video. Don't forget to share it to your friends. It's still your favorite girl, She Jackie Says, your hostess, where the mostest, bringing you the hottest and the juiciest, and I am out. Peace, guys.
Every day, She Jackie Says, with the strength of a woman, She Jackie Says, with the strength of a woman, She Jackie Says, with the